Angeles City is a place I keep coming back to time and time again. It's a place that's ever-changing yet remains familiar. Kapampangans are great cooks, and a trip to Angeles City always means good food. So, it's always a delight to drop by. Today, I'm more than dropping by. In fact, I'm spending a whole day with a true blue Angeles local, longtime friend and fellow foodie, Claude Tayag. And we'd like all of you to come and eat with us.
Next,
what's on the menu? A power breakfast? A perfect merienda? An over-the-top lunch? Tasty and zesty tacos, tapas, paella, cochinillo. Wow! This is the crawl, Angeles City. The adventure kicks off in Cloud's Bale Dutung or House of Wood. Cloud is as good an artist as he is a cook. And visitors to Bale Dutung are welcome to see some of his artwork and wood sculptures. Bale Dutung is open for private dining, and today, Cloud himself is preparing breakfast.
This is the Kapampangan special occasion dish. Pero breakfast dish lang, ha? Okay, ang pangalan niya, we call it pisto.
Okay. Hindi seafood ito, fish too, no?
Hindi, fish lang, fish. Ang Kapampangan mindset kasi, bigyan mo siya ng isang recipe, ang pag-iisip niya, paano ko pa ito mapapasarap?
Okay. How to level up a dish that's already good to begin with? That's trademark Kapampangan. Pisto is a dish made of ground pork, carrots, and peas. It's salty and sour, like bistek Tagalog, and made more delicious with chorizo and parmesan cheese.
Ang pisto, magigisa ka ng, I like using the local chorizo in can. Kasi may pamplit na ba? Yung lard. Kaya ito yung panggisa.
So ito na yung sinasabi mo na, okay, nag-isip sila ng very basic na pork omelette. Ano ko pa sasarapin ito?
Yes.
Ito,
so, wait.
Sige, bisa mo na yan. Gutom na ako.
Gutom ka na. Sandali. Too much talking. So I will pour this in, and then you can just fold.
Ah, so hindi kailangan pa ipaset?
Yeah, hindi mo paset, kundi magsasolidify. You want a curdled kind of texture, yung ano siya, lumpy. So hanggang matuyo. Okay, so ganun siya.
Kaya hindi pala pa omelette, mali pala.
Hindi siya omelette, hindi. Mm-hmm. So this pisto is one of the dishes that I serve here in Bale Dutung for a breakfast menu.
Take note, just one of the dishes. Because aside from pandesal and pisto, our breakfast spread included a very delicious ensaymada by Chona Aison, a Kapampangan favorite tamales, paksiw na bangus with chicharon, and of course, chocolate.
So here's the chocolate Nasa non-limitang ganito, alam mo yon?
Bakit
Espresso. Okay, kasi pag may dumating na bisita na ordinary person lang, sabi ni Padre Damaso, sabi niya sa muchacha niya, chocolate, for aguado or watered down.
Oh, I didn't
Pero
know
kung
that.
VIP, like you, espresso, yan. Again.
Ang lapot, ano? Yeah. Wow! Hindi tinipid.
Hindi tinipid, plus gatas damulag. Yung gatas ng kalabaw. Ito yung pang-creamer namin dito.
Gatas damulag is carabao's milk which makes an already rich chocolate even richer. Look how their chocolate comes in a bottle instead of in tablea form. Cloud is using the chocolate from Everybody's Cafe, another favorite restaurant of mine. See how the consistency resembles peanut butter? That's because it's made with peanuts. Cloud likes to use a blender for more froth. Then he transfers the chocolate to a batirol. Mm. Now that's chocolate eh, Bale Dutung style. Now back to that piece too.
Alam mo yung bottom line, parang we go back to basics, which is a delicious filling on a traditional pandesal. Sarap. Sarap, man.
Great. Kapampangan cooks would like nothing more than to spoil you with their delicious food, and their kitchens are always open. To experience Kapampangan hospitality at its finest, book a private breakfast, lunch or dinner here at Bale Dutung, Manyaman.
Sarap pausap ito. Dahil pinag-uusapan namin pagkain.
Habang kumakain.
Habang kumakain.
Not only is Claude my guide for today, he's also my personal historian and chauffeur. Thanks, Claudie! From Bale Dutung, we head to Nepo Center. The best thing about living in Angeles City, next to the great food choices of course, is its proximity to everything.
As a professional, you know, living here, like everything is within reach. Like in 15 minutes, you're in your destination. You add 5 minutes, na traffic ka na. Ano klase yun, no?
In under 15 minutes, we were at Perfect Loaf. Cloud tells me this is his go-to place for all-day dining, and he finds himself here at least once a week. There's an extensive menu here at Perfect Loaf, and everything looks absolutely delicious, especially the sotanghon. Owner Marcia Nipomoceno says their sotanghon is world famous.
Our sotanghon, the recipe came from my mother-in-law, and I'm happy to say, and I'm proud to say that it is really well known by all people all over. That's why we call it our world famous one, because even our friends abroad, they really crave for it.
Cloud says it's his favorite as well. Let's see if it lives up to the hype.
Para sa akin, this is the best sotanghon in the world. Alam mo yung, alam ko yung secret. I will share it with you. Yung secret ni Marcia dito. Bakit napakasarap.
Ano?
Pakulo ka ng pakulo ng...
sabaw.
Yung sabaw.
Yung broth, yung broth.
Broth.
Oh my God.
Chicken broth.
Sarap dito. We Filipinos have gotten used to serving sotanghon or noodles with calamansi. This doesn't need calamansi. For my taste, ah.
Yeah, exactly.
Sarap. Sakto.
It's sakto. It's a taste, right?
Mm. Tsaka ito, pag nag-napkin ka, nagiging orange na napkin mo dahil doon sa tsuwete.
Ito na yung ano.
Diba?
Oh. Yung smacking the
then.
When you think about it, it's just vermicelli noodles, chicken, annatto seeds, and black mushrooms. But it is a recipe that has been perfected and passed on through generations. That delicious sotanghon is followed by another must-have local favorite. Tidtad, the Kapampangan take on the classic dinuguan.
Ah,
so, tingnan, ito yung sinasabi ko. Ito yung sinasabi ko, soup. It's a soup.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Wow. So, hindi, tsaka yung kalabit ng ano, yung sili.
Yung sili, yes.
Actually,
so, ito yung tidtad ng dinuguan ng Kapampangan, masabaw siya.
Yeah, sarap.
So, and you will see cubes of the blood. It's not really like a creamy.
Ano?
Yes.
The fat is melt in your mouth. It's spicy, it's sour. And the meat is very tender. This is the type of dish you will have to eat with plenty of rice. Diba?
Exactly, yeah.
Wow, sarap. Oh, puto. Is white. Hindi, bagay siya, di ba?
Okay, bakit bagay? Again, it plays on the Filipino panlasa. Yung we love to counterbalance every dish, every subo, something savory and sour with something sweet. Saka tingnan mo na, ito, dipping. Ito yung original Dunkin puto.
For those of you who prefer your dinuguan without the innards, this version is for you as Marcia only uses liempo and pata ng baboy. Another thing that caught my eye in the display was the tortang alibasag. I imagined it to be plump and full of crab meat, and it was perfect with the banana ketchup it came with.
Wow.
Okay, so here. Thank you.
Grabe to, sarap. Purong-puro yung taste eh. Di ba?
Yeah.
You know, it's something I'd like to eat with steamed rice also, but I will not eat that now. Dito tunay yung lasa eh, hindi wala mga extenders ano.
Wala, tsaka yung I think basically you can say Perfect Loaf serves home cooked meals. Na walang shortcuts, I mean real ingredients, walang extenders.
You know one thing I like about Perfect Loaf? It serves home cooked meals.
I asked Claude if Kapampangans ate like this every day and he said yes they do.
We have a joke here. We only eat once a day. Hmm. One continuous meal the whole day until night time.
One continuous meal. Okay yun ah. Actually, I can believe it because we haven't stopped eating. Halo-halo was up next, or as Kapampangans would say, halo-halo, because H doesn't matter. Haha, okay yun ah, Cloudy. Now take a look at Cloud's technique for eating alu-alu.
Start from the bottom. So put your spoon all the way at the bottom, like this. And then stir it slowly from the bottom, parang you're scraping. Okay, can you take a tight shot here? Ayan.
Director na to, teacher,
yes.
Cook, painter.
Ang
daming technique nito, in the end, ubus din yan.
Okay, ha? Kita nyo? Tingnan mo yung ilalim. Without spilling, ha?
To be fair, walang tapon talaga yung halo-halo ni Cloud.
Ikaw, ang dami mong spill. Oh. Tignan mo, umapaw.
Ikaw, Kapampangan ka naman eh.
Wait. Okay.
Remember the Kapampangan penchant for leveling up dishes? It also applies to desserts. To level up this already delicious halo-halo, we were served Tocino del Cielo, eat as is, or better yet, get a portion and eat it with a spoonful of halo-halo.
Ha?
Ikaw mag-describe.
Uy! Grabe, grabe to si Claudie, ibang lasa.
So far, all good. I'm counting on my crawl buddy, Sandy, to have enough tummy space for lunch because I'm taking him to 52 Stone. And I'm not kidding when I say they have prepared a feast. .52 Stone is a Korean restaurant, but they serve Japanese and Italian dishes as well. 52 Stone is literally the English translation of the owner's Korean name. Olivia Woo Isok is a successful interior designer in Seoul who brings her expertise here in Angeles. And look how Instagrammable this space is. Okay, it looks like Sandy's ready to eat again. And ako mismo, I was kind of surprised kasi pag sinabi mong Korean restaurant, the usual barbecue,
you know what to expect.
And all that. Yes, you know what to expect.
Yeah.
Pero dito nagulat ako talaga.
Alam mo, walang ganito sa Manila. Have you seen the, no? You should look at the, ano?
Yes.
The presentation, yung mga plating. Unbelievable. Yeah. Oh, you know, from the, when I picked up the tempura, you can tell it's very crispy and crusty. And I was told, in Japan, you can eat your tempura with just salt, so you can really taste it.
With a little salt lang, hindi yung sauce nila? Yung...
You can.
Tignan na natin. Ako gusto ko yung... Yung crunchiness nung yung butter, yung...
Ano yan? Gulay ba yan?
Kalabasa. It's kind of healthy.
It's a very well-made tempura. You know, you can tell when even the tail is edible. Diba? Pwede yung buntot nakakaya mo.
Tempura pa lang yan, ha? Now let's try the sole galbi jim or braised short ribs.
O, tinan mo, oh. Gumagalon yung ano.
Gumagalon ka. Nanginginig yung taba, oh. Yung ano. Ano ito? Even the tendon.
Litin. Manalo lang.
Ano, lilipat
very ko? Tender, sticky, a little bit spicy, sweet.
Lilipat ka na dito sa Angeles?
Dito na, oh.
Sabi ko sa'yo eh, talagang hindi ka gugutumin dito. I mean, you will never run out of choices here. This next dish is my favorite, Daiji Galbi, or the sweet and spicy grilled pork belly. It is served with homemade samjang, lettuce, mushroom, onion, and garlic. Nakakatakam, di ba?
So, ito yung inihaw na baboy nila.
Ito yung inihaw na baboy, di ba? And then together with kimchi.
Pero diba? One thing I noticed, they don't hold back the spice.
Yes.
Which means they serve it the way they eat it in Korea.
Yeah. Okay, hindi pa tayo tapos. Next, we had the Nagasaki Jampong. Jampong is a flavorful and creamy seafood noodle soup that we both enjoy.
So ito daw yung soup na Nagasaki Jampong. It's a Korean soup. It's made with seafoods, and then it has ano? May ramen
pala. Instant noodle.
Instant noodle ba ito?
Oh,
okay. So may ramen.
Alam mo, one thing I noticed about their soup, may char flavor. Try it.
May ano?
Char. Yung parang
smoke. Smoke pa niya.
Charcoal, di ba? Tapos, perfect for something spicy.
Yes.
Di ba?
So it washes down the... Di mo, nawala yung ahang.
Oh, di ba? Yan yeah. Gale?
Ah, sarap.
So Sandy, kumusta naman? Are you having a good time?
Everything so far, 100%. Boom. Kasalanan ni Cloudy at saka yung kapatid niya, si CJ. Grabe yung tip niyan. Galing. Mga foodie talaga matayag eh.
You can't be from Angeles City and not know and love good food.
May gagawin akong... Medyo kasalanan.
Ito si Claude, mga so, nag-iimbento to rito. Ayan, uy, yeah. Bulalo.
For Sandy, my special guest, I saved the best part. The jelly-like jiggling bone marrow, or utak as we call it.
Now, isang subo. Capture his expression.
Grabe.
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 Are you in heaven or all of a sudden?
That was heaven. 52 stone heaven. But wait, no dessert? Right next door is Cafe Dia, my go-to place for the best and the biggest bingsu. Bingsu is a Korean shaved ice dessert with different toppings, very much like our halo halo. But they're huge, colorful, and totally over the top.
Oh, makita mo yung ice shaving. It's white. Kasi it's made from milk and water. And then, ito yung bean powder.
Okay.
And then, this is the munggo. Ayan.
Mm. Okay siya.
Okay? Okay siya?
Ba? I guess you have to mix it, eh, no?
Mm. Are, maniwala ka? All of that? 290 pesos.
Mahal?
Sobra. Kaya gawin mo nga sa bahay mo. Magawa mo
nga. You know one thing about, I noticed here in Angeles, ang mura ng pagkain, ano?
Relative, yes. Wow.
The next one was a mixed bingsu with two scoops of ice cream and a generous serving of mango and strawberry slices. And that was lunch. From Cafe Dia, we head back to Nepo Center. I'm so excited to show off to Sandy that a Rockwell development is soon to rise in my hometown, Angeles City.
This is our decade in the sense that you will see, I mean, physical evidence of the development. Talaga, it's so fast.
I am told that here at Rockwell Center Nepo, there will be 3 mid-rise residential buildings, power plant mall, and all the signature Rockwell offerings. The first building will be turned over in 2025.
Tingnan mo, ha? You see that open park there? That's the future site of the Rockwell Center Nepo.
Wow.
And this is, you know, the first Rockwell venture north of Metro Manila.
Wow.
Kita mo yung buildings na yon. Straight, straightforward, like 12 o'clock. Clark Air Base na yon. Okay, so in 15 minutes, you're there. Add 5 minutes, na traffic jam ka.
Because of its proximity to Clark International Airport and the range of choices when it comes to dining options, Angeles City is the place to be.
Wala, convinced na ako.
Lilipat
ako
na,
dito. 2025, you'll see me here.
Okay.
Aray.
As the sun sets, we head to Pineapple Coast, a Mexican restaurant and bar owned by Claude's son, Nico, which he bravely opened at the height of the pandemic. I'm always on the lookout for authentic Mexican restaurants, and I'm happy to say Pineapple Coast really hits the spot. From chips and salsa, to well-made ceviche, and not your everyday tacos, everything was delicious.
We wanted to make a tropical Mexican vibe restaurant, and I think Pineapple Coast sounded nice.
Did you know that pineapple is the universal symbol for hospitality, and being in this cozy space with its cool interiors makes one feel right at home?
No, this is a tortilla chips lang. So we have, like, we start off with like 3 salsas lang. So one is roja, one's verde, and one's like a pico de gallo.
What is your favorite among the three?
I personally like the verde. That's the best one for me. For me, yeah.
The verde is from
Tomatillos.
Tomatillos.
It's Tomatillos, yeah.
Tomatillos. Also, yeah. It's green tomato.
Green tomato.
And you're right. There's a tinge of spice, no?
Spice, yeah. They're mostly, we toned it down a bit, but it's, yeah.
Masarap.
Umahang.
I love a spicy kick. Next, we sample 2 kinds of ceviche. Hamachi and tuna.
So this one's a hamachi and octopus.
Wow.
And like a cilantro and vinegar. So if you're into like citrus, this would be the one.
Yeah.
If you want something a little more tart, this one would be, I would recommend this one.
Lime.
Yeah.
So this is something that you don't wrap in
no, no. We use it as a, like an appetizer.
Ah, really?
Yeah, so
you don't put this as a filling also?
No. We not yet. We could,
oh,
no?
Oh, yeah.
We could,
okay.
Watch as Cloud quizzes his son. Good luck, Nico, ha?
Nico, can you tell us more or less the main difference between our quinilao and the Mexican ceviche?
I think our local quinilao, what we have here, I think they use vinegar, and the Mexican ceviche uses more of like limes and lemons as acid, mostly limes, I guess.
So
yeah.
Both
yeah.
Acid, pero in different forms.
Different
one
forms,
is
yeah.
Citrus, the other one is vinegar.
Vinegar,
yeah.
Vinegar, yes. Ours is vinegar.
Sarap nito.
Even Dorin Fernandez describes kinilao, I can say with ceviche as well, is a cooking of freshness.
Sabi niya.
Parang, you know, you cannot go wrong basta fresh na fresh yung ano mo, yung ingredient. So in this case, it's the shrimps and the tuna, no? So, yung tuna mo, ito yung sashimi grade.
Sashimi, yeah. Even the hamachi is also sashimi grade. Yeah.
Nico says he couldn't find a Mexican restaurant he was happy with in Angeles, so he put up his own. The recipes are a result of plenty of research online, trial and error, and definitely exposure to good food from Nico's travels here and abroad.
So, teka muna, what kind of tortilla do you use? What are they made of?
They have a choice whether they want corn or flour.
Is there a difference in texture? Taste, maybe?
Yeah, you can taste the corn.
Yeah.
The flour is more chewy, so...
Ah, really?
So if you want that chew.
What is this?
But most of them we use flour for now.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, for now, yeah.
Diba, you make your own
tortillas? We make our own tortillas here.
And to think Cloud and I had a huge lunch!
I love it. Taka, there are two tacos, no?
Yeah, because it depends on if... So just to soak up all the juices.
Ang sarap. Oh, this is good. And authentic. Wow, I love this.
There's a rule kasi dito, once you pick up a taco, you can't put it back down.
Ah, ganun
din. So the first bite is supposed to be you saying hello.
Okay.
The second one is you make love to it.
Oh, wow.
The last one, you say goodbye. You kiss it goodbye.
Hello. Hello muna, hello. Actually, I can take some of the green chili.
It's good with the chili, yeah. Very good with the firm impression.
Bitin ako without it.
You know what's exciting about this, Claudie? Is that you don't know what kind of feeling you will have.
Yeah.
Yung mga unusual, yung mga feelings,
yes.
Di ba?
The usual na more or less predictable.
Yeah.
Exactly. Let's take a closer look at what Nico served us tonight. We had the gobernador, a shrimp taco with red bell pepper, green chili, and shrimp. The cangrejo, a beer-battered soft-shelled blue crab with cilantro sour cream and pickled red onion. Yaki, a beef brisket confit with whole green chili, bacon and cheese. And birria campechano, made with stewed short ribs, ox stripe, onions and cilantro. And that's just four of many more unpredictable choices here at Pineapple Coast. Thank you, Nico, and good luck to you.
Breakfast, morning merienda, lunch, dessert, merienda cena, and now, la cena, a late night dinner, just the way the Spanish like it. Plus, a very warm welcome from Chef Pedro of El Español.
Estoy invitando a todo el mundo, a todos los filipinos, que quiero mucho con mi corazón, a que vengan al restaurante y disfruten de la comida que les ofertamos, el servicio, y creo que van a tener una buena experiencia de todo lo que acontece en este pequeño lugar. Muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias, Chef Pedro. I'm a big fan of Spanish cuisine, and luckily, when I'm craving for Spanish food, El Español is just a few minutes away from where I live.
Just by the way the jamon has been cut, you can tell it's cut properly, di ba?
Yes. Na yung translucency ng kita nyo to?
There's an art to slicing jamon. And a telltale sign that it is properly sliced would be light coming through like this.
It's paper thin. Okay, let's see.
Uy, okay din to.
Chistora. So homemade daw to? A ver, vamos a ver.
One thing I really enjoyed at El Español is the tapas selection. Especially the gambas served sizzling.
So simple.
Yeah.
But just fresh ingredients.
Yeah, correct. That's the way
ano naman ito. I can imagine, mga three ingredients lang. Fresh gambas, shrimps.
Garlic.
Tapos garlic and olive oil.
Good olive oil, di ba?
Yes. Di ba tayo, we usually wet our rice with the soup or the sauce of like adobo, ganyan, no? Sila, they dunk the bread into the olive oil. Whatever you're eating, pwedeng kalyos yan, pwedeng ano, ganyan. So, their expression is like sinking the boat.
Sinking the boat. Okay yun na. Ako naman, I like the croquetas.
This one are croquetas, and they're made with bechamel. Kasi there are two ways of making croquetas. May made with potatoes. Ito, this is flour, butter, and milk, you know. Mahirap gawin ito, but when you can make it right, it's very good.
Yes, this is good. It's very good.
The star of tonight's dinner was the cochinillo. Organic, locally sourced, and sliced to the plate the way I've seen it done in Spain.
Very tender.
So the plate is going to show you how tender it is. Yeah. That you can cut it with a plate. You don't need a knife.
On the side.
Oh, on the side. Okay, there, the bottom, gravy.
On the bottom?
On the bottom, yes. So the drumstick.
Oh, Claude, sa akin na to.
Sa akin.
Sandali lang. I changed my mind. Can I have the ribs instead?
Kamayin mo na. Ano kan?
Ang nagpapasosyal ako eh. Oh.
Kasi anyway, kinap niya sa plato.
Oo nga.
Oh, he, okay, there. Muchas gracias. Hey.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow?
Oh, wow.
In a very famous cochinillo restaurant in Segovia, the chef smashes the plate after cutting the cochinillo. This is how the tradition came about.
He cut it with the plate because he held the cochinillo earlier. His hands were oily. And the plate literally flew off his hand. No, kaya ginanon. Pumalapak daw yung tao.
Yan ang story. Yan ang
tinulit-tulit. You know how tradition starts? Sometimes by accident.
Sarap yung balat.
Oh my! What a day it's been.
You know, this morning when I woke up, I was so hungry. But I told myself, no, I'm going to be with Cloud and I know he's going to feed me well. I was correct. In fact, I had to pace myself because every meal we had was delicious.
Para sa akin kasi, I've known Sandy for ilang decades. Parang family. No? At the same time, a long lost friend na hindi ko nakita for several years because of the pandemic. Yeah. I mean, even before that.
When I saw him this morning, I haven't seen him in years, so 2-3 years at least. Alam mo, parang magkasama kami kahapon lang, yung ganong klase. I mean, that's how close I am to their family. Matagal na yung friendship, naluluha ako. Talaga, Claude. Thank you very much. I had a grand time.
Alam na naman, basta I truly enjoyed it.
Thank you. Say, likewise. You wouldn't have enjoyed if I didn't enjoy. Diba?
You're most welcome to come back. Yeah.
Na-witness kayo ha, di-imbitan niya uli ako ha.
Pwede ka matulog sa bahay para hindi ka na mag-hotel.
We end the night with a well-made paella negra. Some black tea and plans to return soon to Angeles City.
Why do I keep coming back to Angeles? I have my go-to places in Angeles. Eh. Now, Cloud just added to that list. I will keep coming back to Angeles because for sure, I will find great friends and superfood.
The pleasure is all mine.
Sarap nito paella.
Always something new in Angeles City. And I'm always available to show you around. See you soon.
Galing naman.